Hanson Sports Special, sponsored by McDonald's. I'm loving it.
Something we talked about. We talked about California being the land of opportunity. And a lot of guys got opportunities today, and they stepped up and they swung the bat and really did a nice job taking advantage of it.
Cowboys almost let their heart and their season in San Francisco, but there is a heartbeat for this team. A faint one, maybe, but at least it's beating. I'm Dale Hanson, and we do thank you for being with us tonight. A week in the NFL, and things can change in a hurry. Cowboys quarterback Tony Romo, everybody's whipping boy for that Jets loss last Sunday, is everybody's favorite quarterback again. I actually had a guy email me this week saying he hopes Romo gets hurt so that John Kitna can play again. What an incredibly stupid thing to say, and then we see just how stupid. It's only week two of this NFL season, and the Cowboys already have three starters who can't play, and wide receiver Dez Bryant, the latest to join that list. But the first time the Cowboys had the ball, Tony Romo completes five of his first seven passes, two of them to Jason Witten from their own 20 to the 49ers' three, but the drive stops there. The rookie kicker Dan Bailey, basically an extra point for three, misses. Wide to the right, way wide. And the Cowboys' offense was done for the rest of the half. It's a scoreless game in the second, and the 49ers' first score set up by a very weird play. The ball is snapped over the head of Alex Smith. He throws it deep to Frank Gore. Brady James runs into him, puts the ball at the one. Gore scored from there, and the 49ers up seven. Still in the second, the 49ers still up seven, and now it's 14. Smith to Kyle Williams. They go 48 yards in nine plays, and it should have been that way at the half, but the Cowboys get a huge break. A third down pass that was incomplete had a 49ers player lined up off sides, so they get another play. Still third down from their own 47. But when the defender fell down, Miles Austin was able to go 53 yards, and what should have been 14-0 49ers at the half was now 14-7. John Kitna replaces Romo, who broke or at least fractured a rib on their first drive, and on his first series of that third quarter, throwing for Jason Witten is picked off. But Alex Smith returns the favor. Alan Ball gets the ball back for the Cowboys. And then Kitna finds Miles Austin again. His second touchdown of the day, and now we're tied at 14. 49ers were three plays and out, and it looked like the Cowboys might get their first lead of the game. But Kitna has another pass picked off. He did complete six of his 10 throws, but two interceptions. First play after the Kitna interception, Smith to Delanie Walker, who's running away from Anthony Spencer. It's not a fair race. It's good for 29 yards and the go-ahead score. They added a field goal in the fourth, and they're up 10 with 11 minutes to go. But Romo's back in the game, cracked rib at all, and look at this deal. And the play by Miles Austin. He caught nine for 143 yards, three touchdowns, a huge day for Austin, and now it's a three-point game. Cowboys get the ball back with 4 minutes to go, go 44 yards. They leave it up to Dan Bailey from 48 yards out to tie it up. He does, and they go to overtime tied at 24. 49ers win the toss, but three plays it out, and on the Cowboys' very first play of overtime, there goes Jesse Howard. Starts celebrating early for some goofy reason, but it's a huge play for a guy who had never caught an NFL pass until today. Holly's down at the one. Bailey gets the field goal to win it. The Cowboys save a season. It's a start anyway. 27-24 in overtime.
It was a good hard ball fake in the line of scrimmage from that formation. We run the ball from that formation, and they came and got it. The safety came out. It came out of the middle of the field and wanted to make a play in the run game. I thought the protection was good. The guys came off well. Jesse did a really nice job with his angle coming out of the break, and then Tony sold the fake, popped up, and threw a strike.
That shows that when the opportunity presents itself for guys, that they really take that opportunity, and that, you know, we have some second-string guys that can play, too.
We knew what team we were playing. Yeah, I mean, 14 points that early in the game doesn't mean much. I knew they were explosive. So I don't think it by any means we got away from our game plan.
I thought the guys did a great job tonight, overcome a lot of difficult stuff. Give the 49ers credit. That was a great performance by them. You know, they played really outstanding football, and, you know, I was just proud of our guys to continue to grind. And,